بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب زدني علما.
Again, the next thing we'll try to understand called TCP/IP addressing. Now, TCP/IP addressing is nothing but generally we call it as IP address or TCP/IP address. It's a logical address given to each and every device in the network. Like when you connect all these devices, every device must be given some unique address. Just like every person have a unique name for identification, similar way in the network, every device is identified based on some name called IP address. So it's a logical address which has to be given on each and every device in the network. Without IP address, you cannot communicate, because in order to send the traffic or receive the traffic, there must be identification. And that is what the IP address is going to do. So it is used to identify a specific device in the network, and IP address is like a mandatory for the devices to get identified and to communicate with each other. So mainly we have two versions of IP addressing introduced. Like we have something like IP version 4, which was introduced first, the version like around in 1980s when the TCP/IP protocols was introduced. So they have started with IP addressing. So generally we call it as IP address, just IP address or IPv4 address. That's what we call it as. So basically this IP address was given as a 32-bit address, which means it supports 2 to the power of 32 addresses, around 4.3 billion IP addresses. So whatever the 2 port 32 value. So these many addresses we get in IP version 4. So which means these addresses was enough for the network at that point of time. But soon later on, around in 1990s, around in 1993, they realized that there will be a one day, because of the growth of the internet. Like if you take an example of the growth of the internet 10 years before and from now, there is a huge change. So the number of devices connecting to internet, because it is working on TCP/IP protocol, which means the internet, because of the growth of the internet and the number of devices connecting to the network or the internet was growing. So then they realized that there will be a one day where we may come across a scenario where there will be a shortage of IPs. So then they started working on the new version of IP addressing called IP version 6. And then around in 1999, June, probably around that time, they have come up with something called IP version 6. And when they introduced this IP version 6 and they made it as 128-bit, which means it supports 2 to the power of 128 addresses. So almost like 3.4 into 10 to the power of 38 addresses, where almost like in each and every human can get an IP address. And even if the internet grows more than double every year for the next 50 years, we can survive without any shortage. So they have come up with this solution. Additionally, still we use IP version 4 because they have come up with one more solution called NAT. We'll talk about this in a separate section called NAT. So which allows you to translate maybe you can have thousands of users can access internet with only one IP address. So that is what the translation we call it as, port address translation or NAT, network address translation. So we'll talk about more on this. So we still use IP version 4 in our networks, which means we need to know about IP version 4 as well as IP version 6 both. So in this section, I'll be more focusing on IP version 4 initially, and then we'll also implement some concepts on that. Later on, we have a separate section dedicated after routing and switching topics. We'll be getting into more on IP version 6 also, how it looks and how we are going to assign and how we are going to route, basically all those concepts relating to IP version 6. So in short, this is a brief history on the IP addressing. So we have something like V4 and V6. So currently we'll be talking about more on IP version 4.